Hello everyone. Let's see how to use an interlock block. Interlock blocks allow you to define a condition. If the interlock condition is active, the process object is forced to operate in a predefined position. In EcoStruxure Automation Expert, make sure that you have the library se.appcommonprocess up to date. If you don't know how to do it, please watch our video, How to Change a Library Reference. For the example, we'll control the interlock of a simple motor as a pump. Press Ctrl W to use the interlock block, Interlock Condition Item. The first one will represent the high filling condition of a tank, and the second one, the low state condition. As we are in simulation, we disabled feedback motors. Map all your blocks and build the solution. Focus point. You need to add the function block dpac_full_init inside the resource of your device for a software and hardware initialization. Link your blocks to the pump interlock. Let's configure interlock blocks. Cond signal is a Boolean that corresponds to the condition state. It can even be brought through an adapter. In case both are connected, the adapter has priority on the simple Boolean. Suppress allows you to bypass the interlock. Cond bypass disables the possibility to set the bypass from the HMI faceplate. Cond options defines the position of the device whenever the condition is activated, considering the bypass and suppress status of that condition. If you want to turn off your motor, then set the option as passive. Active 1 allows you to turn the motor on in forward mode, while Active 2 configures the motor in reverse mode. Cond cause allows you to set a condition on the state of upstream blocks. For example, passive means any motor in sequence is running. Active 1 means any motor is running on in forward mode. Active 2 corresponds to reverse mode. Transpassive signifies the input is stopping. Transactive 1 means it is starting forward. Transactive 2 means it is starting reverse. Use not passive when any motor in sequence is not running. Set not active 1 or 2 when it should be a condition other than active 1 or 2. Otherwise, select alarm when any motor in sequence is in alarm condition. Cond type is the parameter used to define the type of interlock condition. If the interlock is a sequential interlock of cascaded objects, such as starting interlock, then cond type can be set to process. Be careful. You cannot force those variables when a device is running. You have to change them directly in your project and redeploy the application. Here is a little tip. If there are several interlocks activated at the same time, the nearest interlock block has priority. Here, for example, it is tank level high. Let's deploy the application to test it. As you can see, motor is now stopped. If we force the high signal at true, motor is now running as the cond option was configured on active 1. You can also access the interlock by the HMI. Open a canvas. By default, motors have an interlock represented by a padlock. You can also add it manually by extending your cat instance and drag and drop it. Start the canvas. Click on the padlock to make its faceplate appear. The red interlock condition is activated. If you bypass it, the color will switch to orange and the condition will be ignored. If your interlock needs to be rearmed manually, you have to check the rearm box. In this way, the reset button will blink and you will have to click on it to rearm your interlock. Finally, the red triangle indicates the first condition that has been activated. You can reset it with this button. That's it. Now you know how to use an interlock block.